Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to show you how I put on my false lashes. A few tips and tricks for beginners, which I hope will be really helpful. So if you'd like to see how I put on my lashes, then just keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing that I would do before doing my lashes is to line my, draw a black line on like the lash line, just above the lash line. Use liquid liner, so much easier. You could kind of smoke it out if you want to, but as like a first timer, I would definitely use like a liquid liner. And you could use like a pen, like felt tip kind of one, or more of a brush one, whichever one you prefer. This then helps the lash band camouflage like into that line, do you know what I mean? So it doesn't look like you've got eyeshadow and then boom, lashes. So it kind of blends it in and they kind of sit on it and it's easier to place on. So I'll show you quickly. So literally I'm just drawing a line. Okay, so literally gonna keep my eye open but look down. Okay, so you've got your line. Next step is mascara. I always put my mascara on before my lashes, just so that it then blends in with my natural lashes. So I'm just going to use the Estee Lauder Sumptuous Extreme. Whatever, just use your favourite one. And I'm just going to coat my lashes. Okay, so next step then is obviously choosing your lash of choice. So I'm going to use these ones. I don't actually know where they're from. Do you know what? I found them the other day with like my other lashes like this. And I can't remember where they're from, but they're really, really cool. I have a feeling they're like Revlon ones. I'm not sure. This is what they look like. Let me get my tweezers so it's easy for you to see. So they don't have a thick band. I have worn these a few times in case they look minging. I'll show you an example of a thick band. Again, these have been worn, so excuse me. So see how thick and dark that band is. For your first time using lashes, I don't recommend using those. It's just harder to get everything blended in if it's such a thick band. And as well, if you're not used to wearing lashes, they can feel quite heavy. So yeah, I'm going to use these ones, wherever they're from. And you want to size them up. So for me, I've already used these. So I know that they fit my eye. But you just want to place them. I'm just going to use this mirror. You just want to place them on top. And like if they are all the way in here, that's no good. Or if it's all the way out here, that's no good. So you want to cut it, and you want to cut from the outside, so these ones are shorter on the inside, so they blend in, and then they get longer as they go out, kind of like a cat eye. You always want to cut from the outside. If you cut from the inside, you're making that inner bit longer, so it's just going to be like a cut-off point, really, really long, and it's not going to blend in very well, so always cut from the outside. So once you've cut your lashes, so obviously I've already cut mine, a long time ago, you want to glue them. So I'm going to use the Duo Clear White Lash Glue. And you want to take your tweezers, if I can, there we go, and just hold them kind of like that. Hold them like this, try not to squeeze them too hard because you will move them out of place and de-shape them, if you will. With this one, as it's a squeezy bottle, I always kind of squeeze some to go up to the top like this and then run it along it. Otherwise, if you go straight on, you're going to get a massive blob and it's not cool. Or alternatively, you could use like a brush on one. These are good too, but I prefer this one. So I'm just going to squeeze a little bit out And then just run it along it. Like this. And you can see I've got a little bit more on the outer side. That way it kind of sticks better on the inner and outer corner, because those are the areas that will pop up if it's not glued properly. So you want to let that dry for quite a while. So I would give it like a minute or so. I'm just going to do my other one. That's my other one. So I literally just sit it down. So I let them sit for a bit, because of the curve of the lash, it will stand up without getting everything gluey. So yeah, I'm just going to do the other eye while we're waiting for it to dry. So I'm going to go back in with my liner. This is the Super Cats liner from Soap and Glory. Okay, so that's my line. Okay, so I've just put my mascara on. In fact, I'm just going to put a tiny bit more on. Okay, and by now our lashes will be tacky enough for us to apply. You don't want to wait too long, otherwise they'll just dry completely and they won't stick. So I'm going to take the first one that we did. Let me zoom you in and I'll show you. Hopefully that is in. Okay, so I'm going to look down and keep my eye open. Got my tweezers. I find it easier to use tweezers than my fingers. And I'm kind of holding it in the middle of the lash band. And I'm going to place it on the middle of my eye. Okay. I'm going to go from the outside, place it. And you just place it on the black line and get it as close to your lash line as you can. With that black line, it's disguising where you put it anyway. And the mascara helps blend it in, so don't worry too much for now. And then I go onto this side and place it onto that black line. And what you can do, you can always hold them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then go back and have a look, see if they need wiggling. And then I go in and press the lashes and my lashes together to make them look real. And then you can always go back in with mascara and kind of blend that inner bit in. Like this. And then we'll do the other one now. So I've got my tweezers. And I'm going to place it on the black line and sit it down. And then I go to the outer corner, sit it down on that black line. Take the inner corner, place it, and sit it on that black line. And then you can hold it. And then go in and squeeze. And then again, you can go back in with your mascara and blend them in. And that's it. Let's move back out. Okay, that is how I put on my eyelashes. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Feel free to leave any comments down below with suggestions for new videos. I'd love to hear from you. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye guys.